They are at a huge red team is at a huge deficit. Or deficit. Bills will recover from this. However, something like that attack will definitely kill. Good at time to save it. Yeah, that was too poor of an angle for him to save. To save him regardless. He would have had to throw a bomb or something in order to save him, but right now this is looking very blue team favored. Yep, fair, that's it. Yep, that's a clean 3-1 from...
You get no sympathy from me.
Ooh. So yeah, experience is going to take it there, I think.
Yeah, definitely experience. I don't think Kunai is necessarily super experienced in doubles. And Bills has mentioned to me before that the BS members like to... They don't have, like, static teammates. They like to pretty much team with whoever is there.
Right, yeah, I've seen Shane in particular teaming with a few different people.
Yeah, he teams with, like, Soul sometimes.
Yeah.
He teams with K-Wells and...
Make fat stacks, Kunai. Uh-oh, we've got a guy with a Yoshi shirt. If Dark plays Yoshi today, that could be at least three Yoshis.
Nah, Dark's playing his new character today.
Is it Diddy? I saw him practicing some Diddy tech off to the side.
Yeah, he's been playing him for a bit today.
Okay.
Different character every tournament. That's our Dark. That's our boy.
That bastard. He must have been Diddy.
Not today. We'll have to see.
I'm taking mud today. Go! I'm feeling pretty good about it.
We'll do our best. As always. It's not all of mine, at least.
Thank God it's not all of mine. We can all just praise that it's fact that we're not getting beat up by all of mine.
So one of the perks about red team is both of these characters are incredibly hard to kill for different reasons. Numerics is incredibly hard to kill because he's really, really hard to hit. And Snake is really hard to kill, or Brimley is really hard to kill because his character is really fat and he recovers really well. So basically, Brimley is gonna be playing hit and run. Both of these players are gonna be playing hit and run until they can like get a setup into each other's moves. Like Brimley will land like a trank, and then Numerics will run up and down smash, and then Brimley will stick him, and then Numerics will combo across the stage into Brimley setting off the stick. That's a common one that they like to do. However, it does not look like blue team's letting them set up these combos. Well, there's another stick. So, Carmack gets popped up in the air one more time, but Brimley dies. Nice awareness by Morgul, making it so Brimley wasn't able to set off the sink work. Cover. Oh, he's stuck. I died for it. That's important. So, this is looking super even. Wow. So, Armax saving his partner. And Numerics committing a little too hard on the edge guard.
Yeah, you can see the moment when he turned around as soon as Armax ran over and tried to reset the situation.
Carmack trying to throw
dunks.
Yeah, he threw like three dares and a bear in there. back area. He doesn't even need to wake up his partner. He's like, no, don't worry, I got you there. He takes the lead.
So, Harmag, I believe, is stuck. So, yeah. Definitely gonna stay more grounded now.
Oh, Riska.
Oh, yeah. Really sets off the sticky early in order to recover. So, this is looking very blue team favored.
Yeah, Numeric takes a lot of damage from
Wow. That F there just took him right out. Okay, so it should be Combo City for Harmag. That's what he does best. Ridiculously hard.
Yep. Yeah, if you miss just one tap, this is going to be all over you.
Yeah, Ness notoriously a character with a not so great neutral, however, an incredible punish game. And in doubles, neutral isn't the biggest issue. Because, there are other factors that go into it. Like, your openings can come from your partner having a good neutral. That's why Fox is really good with other characters that aren't great at neutral, like Wario and Ness. Because he can, like, create openings for them, where otherwise they would struggle to find an opening. And then they can, like, just rock their punish game, like they would with singles. So, this is mostly a scuffle. Grimly got a stick. Hard to say who has advantage here, really. Yeah, wow. So Grimly was a little bit faster there. He could definitely kill her with a stick. However, sets up mine, kills him. Nice awareness by Grimly. I think Grimly can use more mines. Again, especially against a team like this that's very movement heavy. Like, Ike and Ness are very dependent on their ability to, like, move around and, like, trick the opponent's movement. However, when you set down mines, then you force them to go in a different spot than they would be comfortable with. And so, like, I normally recommend just putting, like, the mine on, like, the smash platform or the edge of the stage so that, like, aerial characters like Ness have a lot of more trouble just getting their movement. However, it seems that
this game is very slap happy.
It is. It looks a lot. It looks very disorganized, honestly.
Trying to make some heads or tails out of what position you guys really want out of this, but
they just seem to be like head-on rushing at each other.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like there's definitely a method to their madness. However, I just think this is having a hard time seeing it right now.
And I also think it's favorite red team.
It is definitely favorite red team. Because as I said before, the character, the team that survives longer will win the scuffles. So in the little exchanges where like everyone's just beating on each other.
Yeah, so I'm sure Grimly and Marius aren't worried very much about
a situation.
About that.
By the way, Carmack in 4-4-1 game 1.
Oh, really?
We should update that.
Merrick's is gonna stock up this whole game.
Pretty good read. Actually, it was mostly option coverage, because in doubles, it's when someone does something like down throw and puts you into knockdown, it's almost impossible in a 2v1 to get out scot-free, because one person can just cover half the options, and then the other person can cover the other half of the options.
Yeah, right. Numerics just kind of pop that from ledge and charge that down smash in case of a roll
away.
It's
just a really unfortunate spot to be in, to be honest. And Snake is so good at setting up knockdowns, especially with his down throw. That was something he was known for in Brawl as well, his ability to... He was like one of the few characters that could tech chase in the game, because he had down throw which would send you an automatic knockdown, and you'd have to roll or get up attack. And like,
it's 50-50 sometimes, it feels.
Or if you, or if your reaction time was strong enough, you could literally reaction tech chase throughout the entire stock and then just up tilt them.
Wow.
Once you get up to like 90.
Did you play a lot of Brawl?
Yeah, that was my original game.
Okay.
I played Brawl before coming to PN.
Alright, so I don't know about this dude.
I feel like we're definitely favored both teams about taking late. Because wall stage means I can recover easier. But at the same time, characters that live forever continue to live forever, except even longer now because of bigger boundaries. Unless Harmag's gonna get those punishes. Down air, back air. Oh wow, pulses. And wow, is Vorpal gonna die? No, he's not. Not quite.
That was a tight scenario though.
Oh wow.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Oh, no. Oh yes.
Kunai being a good sport. Cheering our fellow smashers on. Making them feel good about themselves.
That's what this is all about. Nah, Kunai's gonna shit talk his way through this whole day. Got him!
What a calm and tranquil being.
Wow, someone needs to hit Ike. He's had it too good for too long.
I think Americs is getting a little antsy with these down smash approaches.
I think so too.
He's starting to take it.
More sticks. It's like a brutally trying to bait shield out of Vorpal.
Wow, double forward kill. That's
okay.
That's gonna put them back in the game.
Very
honestly.
Solid turnaround.
0% on. Wow, forward smash barely missing.
Vorpal not gonna get anything off that.
Nice down smash. Okay, and now Ness is stuck, and this is looking like a much more doable game for Red Team.
Yeah, and it all comes down to that survivability, I think.
If Ness gets knocked up in the air once, it's all over. Oh, wow.
Okay.
I don't know about Snake in a 2v1. This is...
He's a trap character.
He's a trap.
Without time to do it. Without time to set it up.
I mean, he does, but he doesn't. No, up throw. Up throw will kill. No. Or that, I guess. Okay, so we got a one-on-one going on. We got Brindley versus Harmac. SG Classic. You see this all the time. Just not on screen.
Right.
So, Harmac's ridiculous punish game is not changed by the fact that this is Snake on the screen. He's still going to grab him, and he's still going to
grab out of him.
He's gonna pursue a 60% combo into potential edge guards, into potential death. Because that's just the kind of guy Harmac is.
He's a no-nonsense kind of guy.
Yeah, I respect it. He's very focused. You see him in the player cam. Very easy to it.
unable to blow up the C4.
Okay. Really put, like, got rid of the mine at the exact moment he really needed him, I feel like. Because he got Harmac off to jump on the left side of the stage and then blew up the mine on the left side of the stage. Wow, down air.
Down air to up air setup.
Down tilt to up air.
Down tilt to up air.
Interesting kill. So, curiously enough, if you can't get a stick as Snake, I've heard this from many Snake players, Snake actually suffers from Marth Syndrome, where he has a really hard time killing you, because he doesn't have, like, really strong, he doesn't have really, like, solid and safe normals.
Right.
Like, unless he kills you with, like, a rogue back air or a rogue up air or something.
Yeah.
And he just doesn't have the mobility to do that.
Yeah, he's got a lot of nice setups, but unfortunately at those hyper sets. Yeah, so we're gonna chalk that game to a what if scenario, I guess. Fountain of Dreams this is gonna be a chaotic thing, and I think it's in the end, I think it's still just gonna favor the red team if they can.
They can keep these skirmishes going.
Right.
Oh, Brimley keeps putting his partner to sleep. That's like not something you want to see. Especially the role that Numeric plays on your team, which is like general like hit and run, like doing these little TG's combos and slowly ranks up damage. You put him to sleep, he starts getting hit. You don't want him to start taking hits.
Yeah, Zerozu can get comboed too.
She's good combo weight, and at the same time, she's also really light. Like, she'll die really easily. Especially to a character like S, who can do, like, down throw bear. Wow!
Wow!
That was really bad drive.
Goodbye, stock.
Yep, that'll do it. However, blue team at a very... having a very strong lead right now.
Wow. Yeah, first time I've heard this chant. Oh my goodness. Come on. Come on, Borble. Shielding on platform is something that Snake needs to practice.
Yep.
Let's see if that it might cost Borble, it might not in this stage. He's not at a kill percent yet without a setup, but it could be used as a nice interrupt.
Max taking a very demanding role in this game. He's not really dying as early as he was before. Borble's stock tank, he's doing what he's supposed to do. He's just generally kill early and live forever. Harmac is like the poor man's boss on this game.
Yeah,
where he has like a shine and he has really solid combos, but it's still nice. So
he buys time off of being able to have Pike around to kill for him.
To create openings more so. Both of these characters I feel like struggle to create openings for themselves. They require a read to take control to get like a solid. Like doubles, that's like really invalidated. It's like just the chaos of double makes me feel not as good.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Yeah, so looking blue team looking really poised to just take this one. Grab ledge. This grab ledge far back. What are you doing? Actually, back for a way to kill at this percent.
Yeah, 164.
Even Snake will be living from that. Wow.
And Joe says, no thank you, I'll take care of the dirty business myself.
Yep. That was going to be a very long
no sympathy from me.
For a long and tedious ending.
He was like, yeah, he was looking to try and grind, but...
Pretty much whenever Snake is in a 2v1 situation, he's going to try his hardest to come back. he's gonna get really close. It's gonna take several minutes, but it's not gonna happen.
Right.
Just because Snake doesn't overall have the tools to compete with everyone.
I agree. All right. Game five. You know, I thought FOD was gonna turn out well, turn out in Numerics and Brinley's favor, but I'm not sure what it was there that really screwed them up. Between Battlefield and PS2, I think they're gonna want to go Battlefield.
I think they're just not living long enough. Overall, Brimley's not living very long.
Yeah.
Carmack's making sure of that. Yo. Good night. Take my money.
Kunai's just running around taking people's money now. He's not actually filling them into brackets, just like taking $5 bills as he can.
They're just leaving.
So they off with PS2. There's gonna be some good movement options here for it. Take your suit, make it in my neck. Yes. And up air is gonna kill off the top for first blood. Good awareness for his Vorpal to run up the shield wall. Takes out smash. Brimley needs to live for as long as he can. Forward air not gonna connect. Oh man, and that's two of Numerics stocks. We missed a stick on a sleeping bus.
I think it was a little bit of a bar. Yeah, punishing ice recovery is kind of a lost cause. I think when Ike's off stage, Red Team would benefit more from just focusing on the character that's on stage.
Snake Sticky's putting in the work in this game.
It doesn't really seem to matter, because they were... You know what I said last game about, like, only dying super early? Now, yeah 161, that's not a bad percent to die at, honestly. However, Numerics dying incredibly early and allowing Luki to get back into this really quick.
Yeah, there I'm not sure if Brimley was just too focused on keeping the stocks that he wasn't helping out Numerics as much as he could, but... Blue Team definitely focusing a lot more on Zeus and Zamas here.
Yeah.
And then some nice simple snake stuff to take game five.
So, Red Team clutching out after... what looked like a pretty sloppy start.
Very sloppy start. That was Brimley Numerics.
No.
Yeah, I gotta sign up.